Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to check the Gepper Sea Dolphin, a sub 250g 4-inch racing quadcopter. In this video I'm going to quickly go over its features and specs, show you how to set it up and install a radio receiver, and then head outdoors and test it out. In addition to the plug and play version, which is the one I have, that will require you to install your own radio receiver, you can also get Bite and Fly versions, which come with pre-installed F4Sky RXSR, XM Plus, and TBS Crossfire Nano receivers. In terms of packaging, inside the box along with the quadcopter, you can find some stickers, two sets of HQ Prop 4-inch propellers, a hex key driver and a wrench for securing the motor nuts, two plastic tubes for protecting the radio receiver antennas, and two high quality 20cm long battery velcro straps. In terms of specs, the Dolphin features Gepper C 1507 3200kV motors, which can handle up to 4S LiPo batteries. On the center of the quadcopter, you can find a toothpick style 25x25mm all-in-one F4 flight controller, which came pre-flashed with Betaflight 4.1.1 and features an integrated 20A BLLES 4-in-1 ESC. On top of it, you can find a 40 channels VTX that supports IRC TRAM protocol, has a selectable output strength of 25, 100 and 200 mV, and uses an IPX antenna connector. On the top of the quadcopter, mounted inside this well-printed TPU mount, you can find the Kydex Turbo US2 nano-sized FPV camera. Its lens is pretty well protected by the canopy, and if you'd like to gain extra protection at the cost of seeing parts of the canopy in your FPV feed, you can push the camera farther inside using these two extra mounting holes. In addition, on the top of the canopy, you can find a small shark fin that will help to flip over the Dolphin in case of a crash using turtle mode. A simple linear antenna with a UFL connector is properly secured on the back of the quadcopter, and if you'd like to use an SMA or an RPSMA antenna connector, you can use this cutout. On the sides of the canopy, you can find two cutouts for mounting your antenna tubes. And finally, the Dolphin is using an XT30 battery connector with a pre-soldered 35V 220 microfarad capacitor. By default, the battery leads are not secured to the frame, and I recommend to secure them using a zip tie, so first of all, they are not going to be accidentally cut by the propellers, and also in case of a crash, their pads are not going to be pulled from the flight controller. As for the frame, its wheelbase is 152mm. As expected from Gepper C, it features high-quality carbon fiber parts. The thickness of the arms is 4mm, and each arm, which also provides some protection to the motors, is replaceable, so in case you break one, you don't have to replace the entire bottom plate. The distance between the left motors and the right ones, and also between the back ones and the front ones, is 107mm, so this frame features a true X pattern. And the thickness of each plate that secure the arms is 1.8mm. As for its weight, without a battery, the Dolphin weighs 143.8g. Including an 850mAh 4S LiPo battery, it weighs 246.1g, which is of course below 250g, and in case you want to keep things a little bit lighter, you can also use this 4S 550mAh LiPo battery, which is going to make the Dolphin more agile, but of course reduce the flight time, and including this battery, it weighs only 215.1g. In comparison, the IMAX Babyhawk R Pro 4-inch racer is heavier and weighs 166g. Including a 4S 850mAh battery, it brings us to a total weight of 268.4g, which is problematic in case you need to obey the 250g limitation, and if you're going to use this 4S 550mAh battery, its weight is going to be 237.5g, but I don't recommend using this battery in conjunction with these very demanding motors, since you're going to get less than a minute of flight time, and you are very likely to destroy this battery. In case you've got the plug and play version and you need to add your own radio receiver, first remove the canopy by releasing the three nuts which are located on its sides. Disconnect the camera connector from the VTX and get the VTX out of your way. Then solder your receiver to the appropriate pads which are located over here. Since I'm using an F4Sky RXSR receiver, I'm powering it up using plus 5V, and I've connected the S-bus out of the receiver to the S-bus pad over here. In case you would like to power your receiver using 3.3 volts, you can use this pad. In case you would like to connect a crossfire receiver, you can use RX2 and TX2 pads. Then connect the flight controller to your computer and open up Betaflight. You should note that, by the way, the VTX is going to be powered up, so I don't recommend to leave it connected to your computer for too long because you don't want the VTX to overheat. Under the POTS section of Betaflight, make sure that the Serial RX is enabled next to Yo-2. In the Configuration tab, make sure to configure the appropriate receiver, and by default is going to be set to SBUS. And after binding the receiver with your remote controller, make sure that everything works properly under the Receiver tab, and define your favorite flight modes. After testing out the Dolphin, I can tell you that even though this quadcopter is not going to make sense to all of you, in my opinion, GepperC have done a tremendous job in both designing and producing a well-built and a well-tuned sub 250 grams 4-inch racer with a performance which is very similar to a 5-inch racer. And by the way, even though 4-inch doesn't sound much smaller than 5-inch, you can see how the Dolphin looks next to a 5-inch racer, and as you can see, the Dolphin can almost fit in the palm of my hand. And the only disadvantage of using the Dolphin, in my opinion, as opposed to a 5-inch racer, is that you won't be able to mount a GoPro camera on top of the Dolphin, whereas you won't have any issues doing so on a 5-inch racer. In terms of flight time, you can expect between 3 to 5 minutes, depending on how you fly, using an 850 mAh 4S battery, which is the one that I recommend to use. And if you want to go a little bit lighter, you can use a 550 mAh 4S battery, which should provide you with between 2 to 3 minutes of flight time. So overall, in my opinion, if you're looking for a sub 250 grams 4-inch racer, which is suitable both for beginner and advanced pilots, and is not as aggressive as the Emax PBHawk R Pro, you should definitely check out the GepperC Dolphin. I'm going to wrap up this video with some flight footage, and as always, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section down below. Don't forget to leave a thumbs up if you like this video, and consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notifications bell if you're not already subscribed. See you on my next videos, and goodbye.